we have financial assets, financial liability, and also equity, correct? So the definition is contract that give rise to both asset and liability to both parties. Equity, do we remeasure? No, the share premium, any cost incurred, we minus from the share premium, subsequently no remeasurement. Financial liability, yes, amortized or fair value through profit and loss. Amortized is you plus and then you minus, correct? Not plus effective, minus decent. Fair value through profit and loss means every year we discount and then any increase or decrease, we go to P&L. Okay, now if liability increase, good or bad, the value you discount, the value is higher. Okay, this is what we have in our book after amortize, but the actual value is higher. So liability up, no, means not good, charge to P&L expenses. Okay, not either way. Financial assets means I invest in Maxis shares. So we have a amortized cost. No, it depends whether is it a debt instrument or is it a equity instrument. If it's debt, means amortized, correct? But you must meet two. One is the cash flow test, one is a business model. The business model, cash flow test. This is the direct opposite of liability, amortized. Otherwise, the fair value through profit or loss. This one. Fair value of fair value through OCI. Okay, we must make an irrevocable election. Irrevocable election so that to measure any changes to OCI. Okay, now, so now the company has got financial asset as in equity. Okay, the standard that we use here will be financial instrument IAS 32, IAS, IFRS 9. Ah, okay. Can I? Of course, you got 7. 7 is a disclosure. Okay. So, 32, 39, this one will be eliminated, which will be replaced by 9. Okay. Now, if I buy a share in a company, another company, which is about 10% investment only. I invest in Maxis less than 10%. Which standards do we apply? It can be a financial instrument, IFRS 9. So this 10%, assuming is 1 million. I invest in Maxis shares, 1 million, less than 1%, 10%. It's just a normal investment. What do I do? I can, it can be either fair value, through profit loss, or OCI. Correct. So it's one standard, which is IFRS 9. But if I own 40%, here own share, here also own share. So, but it will be under IAS 28, which is associate, or IFRS 11, joint operation, joint venture, associate, joint venture, but the treatment is still the same as associate, like equity method. What if it's more than 50% in which we have control? IFRS 10. Okay, now consolidation. Can you see own share itself already? Different percentage, you have different standards. Okay, so our point here, business combination that is achieved in stages. Means I may buy share today, I only own 10%. And then what happened is from 10%, I buy another 60%. So how many percent I own now? 70%. So it is from a normal investment. After I buy another 60%, it becomes my subsidiary. Okay. It can also be like 40%. I buy another 30%, it becomes 70%. So it's from associate become subsidiary. Okay. It can also be 60%. I buy another 10%. It becomes 70%. Three scenario. Okay. So three scenario, the treatment will be slightly different. So the key point here is this 50%. My first example here, did I cross 50%? From 10, it becomes, let's say, 70. I use this example here. 10 becomes 70. Is there a crossing of boundaries here, means 50%? Yes. So when we have a subsidiary, we have to calculate goodwill. We have NCI. Understand? 40%, I plus another 30%. Is there a cross in the 50%? We call it the cross of counting boundaries. Yes. So it becomes associate, becomes subsidy. Subsidy will have goodwill, will have retained earning, will have group retained earning, NCI. What about 60 to 70? Is there a crossing of 50%? You did not cross. Okay. So only example 1 and 2, you cross of accounting boundaries. Numbers, last one, you did not cross the accounting boundaries. So the treatment is between transaction, we call it the transactions between the owner. It's all there. Yeah. Crossing of an accounting boundaries. The first two examples. 10 to 70, 40 to 70. The key point here is the 50%. What about 60 to 70? There is no cross on accounting boundaries. It is to be treated as transaction between owners. Percent boundary is not crossed. We call it transactions between owners. Is it okay? Before we look at the format to calculate goodwill, why we call it transaction between owners, you see, before I draw it out, you have to think first. I own 60%, so NCI how many percent? 40. If I buy another 10%, so I now own 70, means NCI become 30. Okay, now if I buy another 10%, it will be 80, NCI become lesser. Okay, now, so is NCI my shareholder? Is the NCI the company shareholder? This is a subsidiary. I own 70. This subsidiary, the NCI own 30. I'm shareholder, NCI also shareholder. So when I buy 10%, NCI will reduce 10%, right? So is this transaction between owner? Both are my owner. Both are owner. Owner buy 10%, the other owner sell 10%. So it's a transaction between owners. Is it okay? So in this case here, we don't have to recalculate goodwill. Why? Because when I started with 70, do I already calculate goodwill? Yes, it is a subsidiary, I would have calculated goodwill. Okay, with 30% NCI. And then when I buy 80, 10, here reduce. So do not have to calculate goodwill anymore. It's already there. So it's just a transaction between the owners. Okay, now? A normal investment or associate becomes subsidiary. Means this is your example one. This is your example two. Agree? Example one is 10% to subsidiary. Example 2 is associate to subsidiary. Example 1 is normal investment 10 to subsidiary. Example 2 is 40% to subsidiary. Example 3 is transaction between owners. Okay? So, investment or associate. Here, investment or associate become subsidiary. So investment is example one, associate is example two. When they become subsidiary, there is a cross of accounting boundaries. So when there's a cross in accounting boundaries, means more than 50%, do we calculate goodwill? Yes, this is the format. Consideration transferred. means the amount that we pay. Let's say I use first example. How many percent do I pay? First example. Considerate transfer means how many percent do I acquire now? 60 or 70? First example, 60. So consideration transferred is for the amount I paid for the 60. And then, do I already own 10%? Yeah, the 10% which was purchased, assuming few years back, the value will be different today, right? So I need to calculate the value of the 10% at today's price. Today. Fair value, not cost, but fair value. Is it today's price? This is the goodwill calculation at date of acquisition. Today's price, acquisition. So my question now.
Yeah. I pay 60% today. So is this price today's price? Yes. And then the answer to find the fair value of the acquirer, our shares that we hold, 10%. The fair value means today's price. They did not say it's a cost. Cost means the previous price. So this is the today's price, the today's price. So today, our 70% today's price. And normally, how many companies will be?
If I buy 70%, 30% will be NCI. So how many methods to measure the NCI? Two. Fair value or proportionate. So over here, let's say we take what non-current rolling interest, a percentage fair value of the new asset or full value. Understand? So fair value, which is the 30%. Okay. Try, explain. Cannot. So how? Still playing games, Then? Looking at what? Assignment, Company send you a survey. Okay, Net asset. This X here. We will acquire equity share, correct? The retained earning, share premium, fair value adjustment, and blah blah blah, and you got an X. It's the same. So any different?
Yes. The difference will be remember this 10%, which is that fair value. So could be calculations the same. But all it means
we buy, if I ask you here, if I buy in year zero, and assuming it's year one now, I buy 10%, which is 10,000 share. At $1. Okay, so I buy $10,000 cost. Okay, cost. 1 year later, the share price is now $1.20. So how much is it worth now? 12,000, correct? So this is at fair value. So did I make any profit here? Yes. So 2, which is unrealized, correct? Now, for the treatment just now here, this 10% especially,
because we measured at 10%, but when we buy it was cost. But now I'm assuming 10 value is higher. So when I value them at a higher price, so I must recognize the profit. So the treatment is assume I sold the old one at this price. I assume I sold the 10% at this price, and I buy the 10% at this price. Sell at this price, recognize the profit. Buy the new share 70% at this price.
Yeah, so recognize the profit means recognize the sale of the old share. Like this. Can I see right? So it's a profit, it could be lost. Here. Today's price here, because I buy at 10%, 10,000. I buy 60%, means I buy 60,000 shares, right? at 120, so this is 60%. Agree? So the 10% is worth how much? 12 now. The 60% is worth 72 lah. So what do I do with this? Consideration transfer. How much? First is the 60%, which is 60,000 share at 120, today's price, 72. Fair value of NCI, or you can put there the fair value of the previously acquired share, which is the 10%. How much is the 10% worth now? 12,000. Correct. How much I bought it for? 10. So I'm going to recognize the 12,000 as my purchase price today. But I bought it at 10 last time. So how much I'm going to recognize as my profit? I'm going to recognize 2,000. Okay. Assume sold today price. So make the 2,000. And then I buy back the 60% and the 10% at today's price. Is it okay? So both my 60% and 10% will be at today's price. You won't have one 60% at now today's price and then 10% of whole price. And then very difficult. So everything at fair value. Okay now. This time you go to, okay, you see, that's why I start with this. Fair value equity here, fair value true profit and loss, or OCI, correct? Right? So if P&L, if you make a gain, go to P&L. I mean, in fact, both also go to P&L. Right? Elizabeth? Not clear, right? Not so clear? Never mind, huh? Double entry for what? The gain. Forget about double entry first. Because you bring in double entry, you have to bring in double entry for Conzo. Can. It's okay. And then the fair value of NCI will be the 30%, whatever. It can be at fair value or at the proportionate shares. You got okay? Yes. Let's try one example here. I give you one example to consolidate. Okay, consideration transfer. Is there a cross in accounting boundaries? I buy 30,000 shares which own 15%. Okay, not? And then now I acquire another 70%. Is there a cross in accounting boundaries? Yes, 15 become 85. Cross 50%. So we have there's a cross in accounting boundaries. 15 become 85. Normal investment becomes subsidiary. So we have to calculate goodwill. Consideration transferred. How much? 630,000. Yes. Go. No, acquire 70%. It's not that you now hold 70%. It's different, right? You acquire 70%, means now you hold 85%. You buy 70%. Means you buy how many shares, you need to know. First, how many shares you acquire? No, 70%? Yeah, you buy 70%, you pay 450 per share. Yeah, you buy one post, acquire 70% means you buy 140,000 shares. Agree? No. There you check here, 15% is 30,000. I buy 70% is how many thousand shares? What? 140 shares. 15% is 30,000. 70% how many thousand? Form 3 mathematics. Correct. Your form 3, what you learn? I pay 5 ringgit for 2 kg of meat. So if I pay $7, how many kg of meat I have purchased? Cross count only. Form 1, form 1, worse. You don't get it. Nah. Chef. Weilin, here. You want this form 1 one or today's one? Form 1, Standard 6, okay. 2 kg, you pay 5 ringgit. 1 ringgit is how many kg? Maybe like this will be better, like this. Wait. 0.5, right? 0.5, no. 0.4. How do you get 0.4? You take 2 divide 5 or 5 divide 2? Yeah, 2 divide 5. So $1 is 0.4 kg. If $7, you times 7, right? 2.8. Huh? Oh, I don't have us. So what you do is you get the 1 kg first, $1 first, by taking 2 divided by 5. 2 divided by 5 times 7. So here, how much is, because I want to find 70%, you find the 1%. How do you get 1%? 30,000 divided by 15%. 1% is 2,000 share. So 70% will be 140,000 share. So you take 30,000 divided by 15 times 70. So 140, done. So you now buy 140,000 shares and you pay 450. So how much you pay for the 70%? Yeah. So 300,000 divided by 15% times 70 and then you times 450. 630,000. After that, we got the fair value of previously acquired share. Acquired interest. Previously is 15%. What's the value of this 15%? 30,000. No, must be fair value means today's price. Times 450. So 135. I bought it for how much? $4. What's my total cost? Yeah. I bought it for $4, 30,000. I bought it for 120,000. Last time. year zero. 120,000. 30,000 share times 4, 120. Today, which is year 3, I did not sell, correct? Not? I buy some more at 450. So the treatment is, I assume I take sell off, the treatment must be sell off the old one, buy the new one. But it's the same share, right? Treatment as I sold off the old one at today's price, buy at today's price. So I sold off at 135. So I have a gain of 50. And then I treat again, I buy another 10% to sell at 125 to come to 400 million. Today's price, 85%. The other 15% will be my fair value of NCI, whatever. Or can we find the NCI in this case, in fact? Can we find the fair value of NCI? Can. How? Fair value is how many percent now? NCI how many percent? 15. 15% means how many shares? Yeah, 15% is 30,000 shares. And the value today is 450. Same, 135. Correct. Okay, and then what you do, you just less your equity acquired, equity share premium, retain, earning, fair value adjustment to get a move in. Okay. So we take a break. Yes.